Welcome to Thoroughbred Racing Action here at Gulfstream Park for this Saturday card. We've got 11 races on deck. We'll send it upstairs to Pete Aiello. He'll give you the scratches and the changes.
Off the turf today with a sealed, sloppy main track. The Tapita track, however, it always dries out and it is always fast. In race one, scratch number six, Boombox Betty. At scratch number eight, Lindsay Smiles. Take note, both the alternates, 13 in other words, and 14, Unshakable, both draw in. Racing at Gulfstream. From the rail, Personify comes out firing and leads early from Laguna Seca, who moves to take second. Xenon is between horses with Matanada. Out in the middle is End Timing alongside her, and mixing it up, shuffling back, is actually Lilybird. It's a real logjam for the early lead. The two out kicked in the early stages, Phoenix of Wit and Botanical Gardens. They make their way to the far turn, and Personify has rail position and the lead. Personify leads and leads narrowly. Up on the outside, Matanada is now second. Xenon races into third, but drops back. Then it's Laguna Seca. Bubbles Up is next at the inside as they make their way to the final quarter of a mile. Personify has the lead. Personify off the corner with a kick under Bravo. Personify now by five. Matanada is second. The battle strictly for minor placings as Personify is running up the score. Personify, the daughter of Sveitstown, for trainer Mark Cassie and owner and breeder Gabe Grossberg. Dominant first race winners. Personify by six in the end. Laguna Seca is in a picture for second that I think she wins over Unshakable, who was third. Phoenix of Wit running home for fourth, 56-3. Holy Kingdom check to last. Good start for the inside horse, Sandwedge, ridden between horses, Our Fortune Cookie, and up on the outside, Lightning Dust. Lightning Dust kicks on with Our Fortune Cookie. They're locked in battle heads apart. They've gone 2.5 better than Sandwedge, who's racing together with Field of Blossoms. Two more to Kiki, and out the back is Holy Kingdom. They're paired off 2 by 2 by 2 in the run past the half-mile point. Up front, Our Fortune Cookie doing battle with Lightning Dust through a 22-3 opening quarter. They have 3.5 on Field of Blossoms, who's got a good trip in third. Ridden fourth is Sandwedge from Kiki, who starts to gain ground outside into fifth now, and still well back to Holy Kingdom. 5/16 away, Our Fortune Cookie throws up the white flag, and now it's a clear lead for Lightning Dust at the top of the stretch. On the outside and running home is Kiki from between horses, Field of Blossoms, as they turn in. It's still Lightning Dust and Diaz with 3/16 to find and 4 lengths to hold. From the outside, it's Kiki from between horses, that's Field of Blossoms, moving out the rail, it's Sandwedge. They come past the 16th pole, Lightning Dust getting tired, but getting tired on a winning lead. It's Lightning Dust to win it, and win it by 3 in the end. Kiki out of time and up for second. Sandwedge is third. Closer fourth in 1/12 flat.
Horse racing or a seasoned professional, we have something for everyone here at the National Museum of Racing and Hall of Fame. From fine art to legendary artifacts, our mission is to preserve and promote the history of thoroughbred racing in America and honor the sport's most accomplished participants. Open year-round and located on Union Avenue, right across from Saratoga Racecourse, adding to the rich history surrounding the oldest racetrack in America. Visit racingmuseum.org.
clear off. Excellent start for Oleg, who heads off for the early lead. Shuffled back out green at the break as Cocktail War as they make their way through the opening eighth of a mile. It's Oleg and Edgar Zayas on top three parts of a length. Latch, the Hatch, is their second. Moving out the rail, attention to detail. Centaur here by Paco, trying to get after this leader. Back from there, it's Baby Back, 2.5 in front of Nothing Subtle. And after an awkward start, it's Cocktail War, last of all, 22-4 for an opening quarter. Into the far turn they go. Oleg with a clean pair of heels. He leads by two over Latch the Hatch. Second, attention to detail, needs to do a lot better than that. Up to the outside, Nothing Subtle's underway in a big way. He's 25-1 and charging into third, just passing the favorite. Five ahead of Baby Back, trying to wind it up from the back is Cocktail War as Oleg tries to find under pressure. They went the half in 46-1. Oleg, Zayas trying to keep his mind on business as Latch the Hatch is floating wide on the corner. Nothing Subtle is still right there on the outside. Off the turn and the stretch drive, Latch the Hatch up to challenge Oleg for the lead an eighth of a mile out. It's Oleg inside. It's Latch the Hatch on the outside. They square off for an eighth of a mile. Latch the Hatch shoves a neck on top. Oleg is fighting, but he's back to second. It's Latch the Hatch. Oleg is second. Latch the Hatch wins. Oleg outrun with no excuse. Nothing Subtle is third. Cocktail War is up fourth in 118 flat. They're off and running. Level beginning. Toward the inside, Bird Wildcat put into play early by Jesus Rios, and he's up to shove a neck in front. Andalay is going to run with him. These two race on ahead of race favorite Joe DiBaggio. Double Play King closes the favorite, in fact, and he's now charging to challenge as Bird Wildcat a bit cattywampus on the top end. On the far outside, it's My Friend's Beer. Saving ground is Money Song, and the one ridden with no speed at all and dropping way back is Cajun's Magic. 23-2 for the opening quarter. They go to the half-mile grounds. Bird Wildcat by a length and a half. Andalay is second up on the outside. Double Play King is now third. On the far outside, it's My Friend's Beer from the rail. Money Song knifing between horses Joe DiBaggio and still way back to the trailer Cajun's Magic. They speed around the far turn at the 3/8, and Bird Wildcat leads by a length and a half. Joe DiBaggio is now second from the rail. Money Song retching up that possibility for Carlos Rojas, third at the inside. My Friend's Beer's next, trying to wind it up from the back is Cajun's Magic as Undelayed drops anchor, and they're at the top of the stretch. It's still Bird Wildcat off the turn, nursing a 2.5 length lead. From the inside, Money Song down the center, Double Play King in between Joe DiBaggio. They come past the eighth pole, but Bird Wildcat has them pulled. Put away now! Bird Wildcat under jockey Jesus Rios in the midst of a gate-to-wire win. They win by four in the end. Double Play King is second. Third is Joe DiBaggio. Closer fourth, either Money Song or My Friend's Beer in 124 flat. On the outside, Honor That Dude was quick into stride. To the rail, it's Leroy Brown, who's marching forward to challenge. In between horses, both Bold and Breezy and Hyper Venom. Outside goes Skull Honor. Down at the inside is Gray Shadow, second last, and at the back and off heels is Premiato. Around the first turn they go. Leroy Brown on the inside, Honor That Dude on the outside. They're in a locked-in battle and heads apart. A length and a half to Bold and Breezy, who's a tripped out third for Van Dyke. Off the rail, Hyper Venom is now fourth. Opening quarter pretty quick here, 23-4. It's a gap of another two to Gray Shadow. Lagging at the back are Premiato and Skull Honor. They're inside 5 furlongs from the wire. Honor That Dude on the outside. Leroy Brown toward the inside. They're still heads apart. In the waiting room with the textbook trip is third running Bold and Breezy. Up to fourth goes Gray Shadow, then Hyper Venom. Angle to the clear red cap of Premiato. And now the trailer is Skull Honor. They went the half in 47-4. They leave the backstretch and move on to the far turn. On the inside, Leroy Brown fights to hold it. Right alongside, Honor That Dude is now second. Time for Bold and Breezy to go to work. He's had the great trip third. Bravo has Premiato wide but gaining ground into fourth. Dropping back is Hyper Venom. No factor at all. Skull Honor as they run for home. On the three wide side, Bold and Breezy. In between horses, Honor That Dude. At the rail, it's Leroy Brown. Far outside, Premiato. Skull Honor wheels even wider. Off the turn and the stretch drive, Bold and Breezy has it now by two. To attack mode, Premiato is second. Far outside, Skull Honor is now third. They come past the eighth pole. Bold and Breezy leads by two. Still trying, Premiato second. Skull Honor is third. Bold and Breezy gets the job done. Can't get a trip any better than that. It's Bold and Breezy for the money. Premiato second. Skull Honor third. 143 flat. And they're off. Well, the future off a step slow. In the middle, 3-0 fires forward to take the early advantage. Moving up on the inside, that's Dr. Jeff. And way out in the center is Classic State of Mind. He's going to float rolling onto the parking lot here. Away in fifth is Competitive Saint in front of Louis the Sun King, then Highly Flammable. El Principito second last and Bella Future trails as they round the far turn. Up front, it's 3-0 in Classic State of Mind, sparring for the early advantage. Competitive Saint tries to find room between horses as Classic State of Mind's getting out. He is completely mugged rolling on, who's wide on the course the whole way. Louis the Sun King slides through at the inside, and they're at the top of the stretch. With the advantage, it's 3-0. From between horses, Dr. Jeff down the center, Competitive Saint. Up the rail, that's Louis the Sun King. Bella Future on the stand side. They come past the 16th pole. Here's 3-0. Here's Dr. Jeff. The doctor's getting up. Dr. Jeff in front. Second is 3-0. Third, Louis the Sun King. Fourth was Highly Flammable. Then Bella Future, 55-4. Start in the middle for Uncaptured Dove, who heads off for the early advantage on the far outside. Five Eyes on Michelle mixing it up. In between horses, My Chutzpah away in the top flight. Well situated while angling to the clear is the race favorite Seminole Sally. She's in the green. Moving out the rail, Blue Colors of Carter's Baby Blue. He says she saves ground now to move up as Seminole Sally shuffles herself back. Outside, Tree Sees Kai, the early trailers Amada and Lunetta Jack. To the far turn they go. The opening quarter was 22-1. A robust pace on the top end for 10-1 shot My Chutzpah, who leads by a length and a half. Five Eyes on Michelle is now second. Trying an inside lane is Paco on Carter's Baby Blue. She has an inside lane for now. We'll see if she can continue forward momentum. Alongside her is Uncaptured Dove, who's still right there. They're a quarter of a mile from home now, and the leader is My Chutzpah. Off the turn to attack mode is Uncaptured Dove. She's still second. From the inside, Carter's Baby Blue trying around a rally from the back. Seminole Sally, there's an eighth of a mile to go. My Chutzpah by 2.5. Uncaptured Dove is second. My Chutzpah still there. Second is Uncaptured Dove lunching late. That's My Chutzpah almost home. My Chutzpah wins. Uncaptured Dove second, well clear of Lunetta Jack, who rolled from last to get third. Then Five Eyes on Michelle in 1:11.2. They're off. Good start from between for Joe from Kiev, who heads off for the early lead. The favorite team captain allowed to run into the bridle. He's up the challenge. Out in the middle goes Chacharrero. Down at the inside, it's Antillian. Rapture Bay is along the rail. The gray is Las Olas, floated a bit wide to the first turn, but not as wide as Divining Stone. Saving ground Lomachenko ahead of Peyton's Day. And well at the back early is Ambushed. Sir Daniel is last of all. Around the first turn they go, and with the advantage now, team captain strides forward to take in a length and a quarter from Chacharrero in second. Joe from Kiev backs off the race in third. Then it's Rapture Bay and Las Olas. They're racing fourth and fifth at this stage, a length in front of Lomachenko. In between horses, it's Antillian, and out three wide goes Divining Stone. Then it's a length and a half back to Peyton's Day. Out the back is Ambushed. They race to the half-mile grounds, and up front it's team captain, thereby a length and a quarter. Chacharrero second through a 48-2 half-mile. Rapture Bay works in between horses. Las Olas gives up ground while three wide. At the rail, it's Joe from Kiev, a length and a half in front of Lomachenko. Then Antillian, wide is Divining Stone. Underway from the back is Ambushed with Peyton's Day as they round the far turn. Three-eighths of a mile away, the three favorites are now 1-2-3. Team captain made first run. In the middle, Rapture Bay, gray on the outside, Las Olas. Joe from Kiev looks for an inside opportunity as the leader is floating out. Off the turn and the stretch drive, that's all for team captain. Rapture Bay rallies forward to take the lead. Las Olas runs at him on the outside second. Team captain is at the rail. Back to fourth, it's Lomachenko. There's a 16th to go. Rapture Bay driven out. Outside, Las Olas. Inside, team captain's battling back. They come for the wire. Here's team captain back through. I don't know if he got there, but what a tenacious run. Team captain, he looked dead beat at the top of the stretch, and he's in a win picture. Rapture Bay right alongside. This comes down to a head bob in 1:44.2. Amnestic got away quickly, not quicker than Street Earnings, who fires through at the rail to take the lead. Happy Runner away in the top flight, and he's charging to challenge. In between horses goes Mr. Abario out in the middle of the racetrack at Social Long Distance on the improve. Quester's just inside of him, and Amnestic's going to back off. He'll land mid-flight about seven lengths behind. Already dropped over to the rail from the 10 post is Whiskey Park, racing in front of Blue Slide Park. Mutawid is three wide. Out the back is Battle Call, and the trailer is Guaranteed Spec as they make their way around the first turn. 24-2 for the opening quarter, Street Earnings by a neck. On the outside, Happy Runner is second. Far outside, Social Long Distance, three wide, Quester. Good trip for Mr. Abario. Jade J stays parked at the rail. It's a length and a half back to a moving up Battle Call. He's the gray on the outside. And Amnestic, no place to go yet. At the rail, that's Whiskey Park. He's seven lengths off the lead. He's stuck in traffic as well. Trying to wind it up from the back, Blue Slide Park and Mutawid. And still at the back is Guaranteed Spec. They went the half in 48 seconds flat. They leave the backstretch and move on to the far turn. Street Earnings has been in front throughout. Here comes Battle Call with a bid three wide, and it's a bold bid now. Battle Call takes the lead, and the between horses, that's a Happy Runner. Off cover, Mr. Abario fighting on Street Earnings from the inside. Not much really running home from the back. Blue Slide Park and Amnestic, they're close enough. If good enough, they're on their way home. Battle Call with Street Earnings fighting back along the rail. Down the center and coming on now is Mr. Abario. than Blue Slide Park. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Street Earnings, he's very game. Battle Call right alongside Mr. Abario tries to pick him off. Here comes Mr. Abario. Street Earnings at the rail. In between, Battle Call. That's a win photo. Battle Call's in the middle. He might have got it. It's a photo between him, Mr. Abario, and Street Earnings. 142-4. They're off. The favorite Adios Babe broke the line well. So did the other favorite, Star of Saturn. Out in the middle is moving up Julie's Legacy. Driving through at the rail, it's Major Price in the run to the half-mile point. It's now Julie's Legacy, who will cross over some and lead by a length and a half. Atalanta, Alexandra, is now second. Adios Babe is between horses outside and Vallesta, inside and Major Price. Two back to Star of Saturn, who shuffles herself back after a good break. Then back to Southern Palace, and a long way behind is the Brown Eyed Beauty. Around the far turn they go. Julie's Legacy, fleet of foot for Zayas in front, three parts of a length. Atalanta, Alexandra, in attack mode, second. Three wide Vallesta, four wide Adios Babe. Staying parked at the rail is Major Price, winding up from the back Southern Palace, then back to Star of Saturn and well back to Brown Eyed Beauty. They reach the top of the stretch through a 45 and 4 half mile. It's Adios Babe with all the momentum out in the middle, challenging Julie's Legacy, who tries to find under pressure. Eighth of a mile to go. Adios Babe driving forward now to take the lead. Julie's Legacy fighting the good fight. She's back to second. She'll try to hold second from an oncoming Star of Saturn, but it's Adios Babe clearing off to win it. 2.5 clear in the end. Second, Julie's Legacy. Third, Star of Saturn. Then Atalanta, Alexandra in 1:10-2. Runners away. In the middle, Catimon gets the first call and fires to a pretty easy lead from Oconee Life, who comes away in a flanking role. On the far outside, it's Titan, tightened up for racing room, as Gentleman Caller with Prince David alongside him. Last shall be first saves ground toward the rail in front of Highland Peak, and the trailer is Will of the Warrior. And they run around the first turn. It's the Catimon in front by an echo, Oconee Life. Turning up the heat second, Titan is a three wide and Keen third. 2.5 to Prince David. He's now fourth up to the outside, Highland Peak. Saving ground at the inside, last shall be first in front of Gentleman Caller, who is now at the back of the field. Will of a Warrior is last of all, however, and he's about 15 lengths off the front. They go to the half-mile point. It's Catimon and Leonel Reyes carving out the numbers. In front by half a length, Oconee Life. Right alongside second, a length and a half to Titan third. Fourth at the rail, that's Prince David, followed fifth by Highland Peak. Dropping back tamely, last shall be first, passed outside by Gentleman Caller, and still far back to Will of a Warrior. Around the far turn through a 49 3/4 mile, here's a Coney Life surging forward on the outside to take the lead. Calimon is second, Titan is third. Island Peak tries to rally with an inside lane. Boulanger has him only 4 lengths off the lead while closing ground. Off the turn in the stretch drive, 3/4, 113 3. It's a Coney Life at 8-5 who sets sail for the money. Island Peak chasing with determination into second from Calimon, then Titan. Final 16th of a mile, Jaramillo's got it won on a Coney Life. A Coney Life for Rohan Crichton to win it and win it by 4 in the end. Second is Highland Peak. Third is Calimon. Fourth is Titan. And Will of a Warriors up fifth for the high five in 142 flat.
That wraps up Thoroughbred racing action here at Gulfstream Park. We'll be back with you tomorrow for a 12:50 post time. 10 races on the card. We'll see you out here.